You know, every day my daughter takes the Delaware Bridge from southern New Jersey over into Wilmington, Delaware, where she works. And then she takes it back to go home. Without that bridge, she can't get to work, and without that bridge, she can't get home. That's how important bridges are. I myself love bridges. Maybe you love bridges too. I love the San Francisco Golden Gate Bridge, and I really love the iconic Brooklyn Bridge that takes people from Brooklyn into Manhattan and back. Bridges are an important part of our life. We may see them as just simple, ordinary things, but they're really, really important to us. And today, I want to tell you why bridges are important to me. Bridges are important because they help us get across difficult terrain. Maybe it's a deep valley or a body of water or traffic. But before we can have a bridge, we've got to have a bridge builder. I've spent the last 25 years of my life being a bridge builder. And the most important thing about being a bridge builder, and there are so many things that we could talk about, but the most important thing I've found is starting with common ground. People have to learn that they do have some things in common. And at the very basic level, we're all human beings, and we can even just start there. Common ground is a principle that allows people to come out on the bridge and begin to learn about each other, begin to understand one another, respect one another. Even though we have political differences, racial differences, economic differences, all kinds of differences, there's still something about me and another person that's common. Maybe we both like to fish or hunt. Maybe we're into cars. Maybe we like football or the NFL or the NBA. It doesn't matter. Whatever is your common ground with another person gives you a starting point to cross a bridge, to get over a tough difference between you. And that's what bridge building is all about, taking people from different perspectives and helping them have a healthy conversation about understanding one another so that they can make some progress in not being hateful or disrespectful or unkind, but to really begin to understand that even with our differences, we have something that we can share. We have something we can learn from one another. We have something to gain in trying to at least be friends. As Abraham Lincoln once said, the best way to get rid of an enemy is to turn him into a friend. And that's what bridge building is all about. That's what bridge building does. It turns an enemy, or at least it can, turn an enemy into a friend. And that's why I love being a bridge builder. For much of my childhood, I was raised a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. I was a Mormon. And at age 14, I went to a Christian camp and had a born-again experience and became an evangelical Christian. One thing I knew is that Mormons and evangelicals didn't get along. I knew that as a Latter-day Saint, and I began to understand that as an evangelical, that we argued all the time. We argued about doctrine, we argued about theology, we insulted one another, we condemned one another, we didn't think well of each other. It was a lot of conflict, a lot of antagonism. But you know, as I continued my Christian life, I eventually went to a seminary to learn to be a pastor, to come here in Utah and serve in this area. And one of the things that I began to discover was this principle of common ground. And as a seminary student, I was also a college pastor at the time, so I walked over to an LDS ward house on a Sunday morning, introduced myself to the bishop and said, our students would love to learn from some of your young adults, and we were wondering if there was any chance you'd ever come to our place. We would love to feed you a meal and get to know you better and have several of your students tell us why they are members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. He was so amazed by this idea and so intrigued that I would come all the way over to his place and talk with him about this that he said, sure, but why don't we have a couple of your students tell us why they're evangelicals and we could learn from each other. And I said, that's a great idea. And that's all what common ground is. It's beginning to establish that relationship. And you know, 25 plus years later, we're still doing it. We're still doing it. We have evangelical college students that come in from California, places like Biola and Westmont and Azusa Pacific, and they meet with students at Brigham Young University and the Institutes of Religion, and we have students talking with students, we have academic scholars talking with academic scholars, we have evangelical leaders talking to Latter-day Saint leaders. And it all started with common ground.